Hello everybody, Reed here. Welcome to a vintage cube draft video here on channelfireball.com. We are wasting no time as I've already opened my pack and I've already got an ancestral recall auto selected here. So that's one of the best cards, of course, in the format, in the whole game of Magic. I'll be first picking that. And we're off to the races from there. As we do get into the draft, I want to remind you that you can pair this video content with written stuff over at the Channel Fireball website. I also want to encourage you to look into the Edge video series. So this is not written content. It's video, but this is our premium offering. It's for subscribers who think that's a good fit for them. You can check out the first video for free. 9 more available to subscribers. But a lot of people worked really hard to bring you the Edge series. And if you think it's the right type of content for you, please do check it out. I also want to thank Ultimate Guard for making my content possible, being a longtime sponsor of me and my teammates. Thanks, Ultimate Guard, and thank you, of course, for watching. Ancestral Recall is the first pick. Can go a lot of directions from here, but I know I'm going to play this card. I'm going to have blue mana in my deck. If this Spellseeker could wheel, that is a card that becomes, you know, tremendously valuable once you have a card as strong as Ancestral. Moving to pick 2, we have a couple different land options: Fiery Islet, Xander's Lounge, Marsh Flats. Bolas of Citadel is really good with Tinker specifically, as is Mirror Battlesphere. But I think realistically, I'm going to take one of these blue cards, and I do believe Narset, Parter of Veils, is the strongest. You know, just good Planeswalker increases my access to Ancestral Recall if I'm fortunate enough to get some. Draw 7 cards like Time Twister, Wheel of Fortune, Memory Jar, whatever it might be. Narset skyrockets in value. So I'm going to just choose that as a great follow-up to Ancestral Recall. And we're moving into probably just a blue control deck, though it could still be like a combo draw 7 style. And wow, would you look at this pack. Pick 3, and there's still some super broken cards. Balance, Demonic Tutor, Tinker, Mana Leak, Helm of Awakening. I mean, I think I have to narrow it down to Demonic Tutor or Tinker here. Demonic Tutor, of course, is quite appealing when I have a card as strong and as cheap as Ancestral Recall. Tinker, you know, maybe the Bolas of Citadel wheels, really, really powerful card. The key to making Tinker work is getting some of those cheap mana acceleration artifacts, which I didn't get a Mox in my first pick. I got a different card instead. So I think I'm going to take the Demonic Tutor because this is more guaranteed to work, whereas the Tinker is high upside, but also there's some world where it just ends up in my sideboard when all is said and done. Yeah, let's take the Demonic. Now, had I taken Tinker, I could choose Mox Opal, but Wheel of Fortune, really good with Narset, also just pretty nice little combo, high-powered start here. I think it's got to be Wheel of Fortune, right? Now we have Factor Fiction. We have Blightsteel for the alternate universe where I had taken the Tinker. Burgi, God of Storytelling. I'm going to take Factor Fiction because I can still use it in a combo deck, but it's also just if I end up blue-black control, you know, Grixis control, this is a good card in pretty much any blue deck. Seems like a safe pickup. Watery Grave, Night's Whisper, Frantic Search. I think it's got to be Watery Grave. Now, Leovold is also strong with Wheel of Fortune, but that's getting a little bit crazy with the colored mana requirements. Mana Flare is an interesting combo card. Shark Typhoon is the best card for just a regular old control deck. Dothy Voidwalker is powerful, but it is double black. I think I'm going to take the Shark Typhoon. Zagoth Triome, blue, black, green. Portal to Phyrexia, Torrential Gearhulk, which is looking good with Ancestral and Factor Fiction already. Graven Cairns. So do I take the Gearhulk or do I take, you know, a mana source, a mana, mana fixing type land. Gearhulk's looking pretty strong. But no, I'm going to take the Zagoth Triome. Now, Grave Titan over some artifacts and some wrong color lands. Bolas the Citadel Wield if I did, you know, and the Battle Sphere if I had taken the Tinker, but at this point it's going to be Black Cleave Cliffs and I'm not really going for an artifact themed deck. I'm actually, like, as much as it pains me to say it, I'm not a big fan of Vendilion Click. I think it's just time has kind of passed it by in terms of the stats and the power level of the card. I would probably play it if I ended, you know, if the draft ended and I was playing blue and it was in my pile. But I think it's kind of marginal and I'd rather have the mana fixing instead. Helm of Awakening. There's probably still some world where I do a combo strategy. So both of these would be speculative picks, either the Helm of Awakening in case I go combo or the Balance in case I splash white. Let's take the Helm. The Lich is a good card in certain matchups, or this Scrubland. I guess I'll take Scrubland. So here the question is, what happens if I wind up in a reanimator strategy? I think the answer is that I'd rather have Woodfall Primus in a reanimator strategy compared to Unas Prowler. All right. So at this point, I'm like first choice blue-black control, second choice storm combo, third choice reanimator. But still some different directions I could go here. And I open up a pack that has some artifact mana, Remand, the One Ring, Rafine's Tower, Toxic Deluge, Expressive Iteration. I think I'm going to take the Remand just to be, you know, nice and low to the ground, which is, of course, important when you don't get the broken artifact mana. I don't expect the One Ring to wheel. But if I could wheel, say, Rafine's Tower, Expressive Iteration, or Toxic Deluge, that would be really nice. And I think that's realistic that I'll get one of those back from that pack. All right, Mizzium Mortars, Jace Vryn's Prodigy, Magma Opus. If I had taken the Torrential Gearhulk, that would be nice. That's actually a pretty sick combo. I didn't have that on my radar. Like I'm not sure I was aware that Magma Opus was in the cube, or I certainly wasn't thinking of it when I passed the Gearhulk, so a little bit of regret there. Chrome Mox. Chrome Mox, of course, not good as the classic five Moxes, but in a world where you have a lot of card advantage and just need to keep pace in terms of speed, Chrome Mox can be a really good fit. So I'm leaning towards that. Necromancy, interesting. Jace, interesting. But yeah, I'm going to take Chrome Mox. Force of Negation. I think it's first choice Force of Negation, second choice Spire Bluff Canal. It's funny, like, you know, 10 years ago, I used to draft control decks basically all the time when I drafted Cube. These days, I don't do it that often because the other archetypes and threats have kind of risen to match the control cards. But this is still a really, really good setup for it, you know, with Ancestral Recall and some cheap counter spells. So I'm happy to be drafting control here. And now looking at Inferno Titan, Subtlety, Daze, maybe Third Path Iconoclast. I'm going to say Subtlety is the best option here. This is a card that you can either cast for four mana or it can save you if your opponent, you know, powers out some kind of crazy Titan or something ahead of schedule. All right, Scalding Tarn, that's perfect, having the Watery Grave already. this like effectively a tri land. Creeping Tar Pit. So, by the way, I'm not sure if I'm playing red. The Wheel of Fortune's not that good as a standalone card in the deck, but of course, you are going to win the game if you get Narset Wheel of Fortune. It probably depends if I get any other red cards, what kind of mana fixing I get, if I get more fast mana. We're keeping an eye on it at any rate. Interesting. Okay, Call of the Ring, Recurring Nightmare, Faithless Looting. Recurring Nightmare is the most powerful of these cards. I guess the same is true of Call of the Ring and Recurring Nightmare, which is they're both really good, but I need to be able to put creatures on the battlefield in order to use them. But maybe Recurring Nightmare is strong enough that I should just make that happen. Some world where I would take the Faithless Looting to go with like Grave Titan and Woodfall Primus and try to do a faster reanimator strategy. But let's just take the Recurring Nightmare as a speculative pick. This is what? White, green, black, wrong color combination. Survival, Recurring Nightmare. But there's a lot of really nice off-color cards here. Anything I can do with them? I mean, I could take the Grist. I do have Zagoth Triome and Scalding Tarn already. That's probably my best bet. Who knows if I'll choose to play it. Oh, I also didn't mention, but I got a really late pick Vampire Hexmage just in case Dark Depths shows up. I don't usually go for that combo in cube draft, but if they're just going to hand it to me, like, you know, 15th pick, then I will play it. All right, so here's my opening pack. None of the cards that I wanted wield. So that means Expressive Iteration, Toxic Deluge. I think there was some dual land. Yeah, Raphine's Tower. None of those wield. The One Ring also. So here am I taking, like, Misery Shadow, Talisman. Guess Talisman? Not too happy about it. Oh, it gave me the wrong card there. So that was a misclick, Flicker Wisp. Magma Opus. I mean, I guess I could just cast this for 8 mana. Feel like things are kind of drying up for me. Not thrilled with the way this pack went. Here we have Soul Transfer. Or Blooming Marsh to get me closer to the Grist. Scratch that. Mizzix's Mastery, having just picked up Magma Opus, that's just good enough for me. Even if I'm casting 4 mana Ancestral Recall or Factor Fiction, that's fine. Inferno Titan. Peatland to get closer to the Grist. I'll play an Inferno Titan. I don't mind that. Can't imagine using any of these. All right, we need some help in pack 3. I need to, I think, tie together this kind of Recurring Nightmare package, maybe just get some more cheap, good cards. But boy, man, if you told me I was going to start this draft and open Ancestral Recall and Mana Drain, I would be a happy camper. I think with these two cards, it's like kind of, it's almost hard to mess up. Whatever your other 38 cards, if they're cube power level cards, you're going to have a good deck. So I'll be taking Mana Drain here, keeping an eye on Blood Crypt, Damnation, I hope one of those two wheels. There's some other stuff that maybe you could make a case for, like Hard Evidence or Dragon's Rage Channeler does give me a cheap creature for Recurring Nightmare. But the plan A, look, I'm going to Mana Drain your 4 drop and then cast a Titan. That's good enough. Mystic Confluence is excellent, as is Dak Faden. I will be taking one of those two cards. Which one do I want is an interesting question. Dak Faden Narset can be a cool combo. Mystic Confluence is just great for a deck that wants to pass with mana available. If I had taken the Torrential Gearhulk, the Mystic Confluence would be exciting. I do have Mizzix's Mastery. Does that move the needle at all? bounce some creatures, draw cards, sorcery speed. Dak Faden can go with like a recurring nightmare or Mizzix's mastery strategy as well. Not expecting either of these to wheel based on how the draft is going. So pretty important pick here. How's my red mana fixing looking? I have Scalding Tarn, Blackleaf Cliffs, one mountain, a couple mountains. Ugh, boy. I'm going to take Mystic Confluence. I'm not too sure about that pick, but the tiebreaker for me is I'm not sure how solid my red mana is going to wind up. Okay, so now a good pack for me. Grief, Jace, Coalition Relic, Memory Jar with the Narset, Treachery, Underground Sea. I'm thrilled with any of those cards. I think Treachery is the best of the cards that I'm like tapping mana to cast. But I could see Underground Sea, Relic, or Grief being stronger than those. Stronger than Treachery, just for kind of the overall structure of my deck. I don't have a lot of black cards, so I'm not going to take the Grief. I have enough blue-black dual land, so I'm not going to take the Underground Sea. So Relic or Treachery? Let's go Treachery. I can't resist this card. Now we have Cryptic Command. Don't think it's a great deck for Dark Confidant. Misty Rainforest can get me a blue-black dual land. Not a blue-red dual land, though. But it does also get me closer to Grist if I choose to play that. Odawara, Chart of Course, kind of marginal options that would make my deck if I got them, but I'm not going to spend a pick on them. Kind of between Cryptic and Misty. And I'm going to choose to take the Misty and then get the Grist in there. I think that's a good setup. Everflowing Chalice, Archon of Cruelty, which I do have Recurring Nightmare. Caracas is just strong enough that I would put it even in a Grixis deck. Murktide Regent is a good deck for it. Murktide, Caracas, Archon, Chalice. I don't like how the Chalice is only colorless mana, so I'm going to skip that one. Could be Murktide Regent. It's like 4 mana for a 5/5 flying. Archon is only good if I can Recurring Nightmare it out. All right, let's take the Murktide. It's a little slow. I do generally like the card. Very late for Animate Dead. If I had seen that earlier in the draft, I think it would have changed the direction of how things were going. Animate Dead is good enough that you can just play it like as a value card because you can take things from the opponent's graveyard. Looks like I'm not super stocked on ways to discard creatures, but I think Animate Dead is just the strongest card for me. And if I can pick up even like one more way to discard a Titan, that's going to become pretty strong. All right, here's a red-black dual land, which I could get with the Scalding Tarn. Here's a Polluted Delta, which no red-black dual land, so that's just is what it looks like. I don't think I'm going to take Vampiric Tutor. I already have Demonic. And then Massacre Worm I do like, but probably not. Don't need another 6 drop. I guess I'll just take Polluted Delta, sure. Extra fetch lands for Delve never hurt anybody. All right, I think I have to take Duress here because I do need more cheap interaction. Bone Shards or Waterlogged Grove in a slightly different world would be appealing, but I think Duress, like I think this card is just great. I have first picked Duress and will again. I think it's really, really good for me right now. Damnation came around. Pretty happy about that. It's a good deck for it. So Tameo, I mill some cards. I regrowth something. Triplicate Titan. It's good to animate dead or recurring nightmare. I don't know how realistic I am to actually set that stuff up, but it's probably the card I'm most likely to use. Memory Jar, Sower, Time Warp, Graveyard Trespasser. So Time Warp, I don't have enough Planeswalkers to be really excited about that. Memory Jar, only good with Narset, not good with anything else. Maybe I just take the Sower. Sower's, there are matchups where Sower is amazing. Wrong Mana Fixers. Yeah, probably not using Sundering Titan. Could see a world where I board in Reclamation Sage. I do have access to green mana and then can go well with Recurring Nightmare. My big regret from this draft is I just didn't really get there in terms of the Reanimator package. So I have to just build kind of like a fair deck that maybe has some stuff in it incidentally. I'm not thrilled with my mana. Like, I'm probably just going to splash the Grist off of Zagoth Triome and no forests. Zagoth Triome and three ways to search for it. Probably enough. And then red mana. Scalding Tarn, one mountain, Black Cleave Cliffs. That gets me three. Then, like, this can make a treasure, so it can work with Mizzix's Mastery. I don't know about the red, though. That's, I have all these little, like, small packages that I feel like are just not going to work out. What about white? I have Scrubland and Polluted Delta to splash, like, a Kenrith. Man, it's all pretty thin. I mean, all of this stuff is good. Just blue-black good cards. I like that. So this is 18 blue-black good cards. I can definitely just throw in the Animate Dead. Vampire Hexmage is like, that's a card that I can play early and just kill a Planeswalker. It's not the worst ever. I could definitely play a small number of red cards. Like, just maybe skip the Inferno Titan and play these three with one mountain. Wheel of Fortune is just bad, though, if I don't draw it exactly alongside Narset. It is technically a discard outlet, but that's not exciting to me. Yeah, I don't think Recurring Nightmare is, I think, is just too much setup. But as I said, Animate Dead is fine, even to take things from opposing graveyards. Can you Animate Dead a Grist? No, it would fall off, right? You can reanimate a Grist, but you can't Animate Dead it effectively. Fiend Artisan is just way too bad. Well, why don't I plan to add one mountain? Of course, Magic Online reset all my sorting. I'll add the Magma Opus and the Mizzix's Mastery and not the Wheel. I'll add the Animate Dead just as a value card. This is up to 21. I mean, second mountain plus Inferno Titan. Hexmage is fine. Sundering Titan, Rex Sage. I'm going to play 17 lands plus the Chrome Mox, which is maybe a tiny bit heavy, but I kind of like it. Twenty-one cards in front of me. Hex Mage is fine. Could add that. Porcelain Legionnaire. Oh, it's so bad. How demanding are my mana requirements for blue and black? I do need to have double blue. My black mana requirements are not that steep. So would the second mountain hurt me a lot? Inferno Titan is really tough on the mana, but it is definitely the card that is most appealing to me in my sideboard. So anyway, I play 18 lands with the Inferno Titan. That would be 19 mana sources plus some card drawing, but I do definitely want to hit like my first four land drops. Sorry, everyone, just agonizing over this last card choice. Let me add some lands and count my number of blue and black sources. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 black. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 blue. Feeling like one swamp is enough. All right. I'll do the second mountain and the Inferno Titan and just probably won't cast it until the late game a lot of times. So there's up to 17 lands. There's the Inferno Titan. And then just toss in the Hex Mage. Does that make sense? Is Urborg good enough? Urborg's good enough if I'm playing the Hex Mage. Not sure it's like necessarily better than another swamp for me otherwise, because it could hypothetically fix the opponent's mana. All right. So here you have it. It's, I would say, 37 cards to a really good deck. As I said, any draft where you open Ancestral Recall and Mana Drain and have a reasonable deck, I think you're going to have a good chance to win. Let's see if I drafted, if I made enough sketchy draft choices that I can mess that up. I do feel a lot of regret about the way I drafted, like the having picked up the Magma Opus and the Mystic Confluence. The Torrential Gearhulk would be awesome for me. And I took like something, I think I took a land over it. And then investing some picks in like Recurring Nightmare and Animate Dead, but not quite getting there on the Reanimator package. I think if the Animate Dead had been in pack one instead of being late in pack three, I could have taken things in a different direction. But anyway, just a lot of weird like tangents that I did over the course of the draft that didn't quite materialize and ended up just a tiny bit short on playables with a little bit of a sketchy red splash. But I think I have enough strength and consistency in this deck that I'm not disappointed with how it turned out. So please stick with me for the gameplay. I'll be right back. All right, friends, welcome to match number one of this Grixis Control Cube Draft. And, well, I have an island and Ancestral Recall, so that's good enough for me. I'm not necessarily going to fire it too quickly because then I would just have to discard the hand size. So I think I'll take my time, maybe get the Narset down first, and then plan to Ancestral on, well, either turn 2 or turn 4. I guess end of turn 2 makes the most sense. Tap land, then tap land pass, end step, Ancestral, untap, play Narset, and then maybe not activate her. Suspicious Stowaway. Good card. Narset's good against it. Cool. Let's respond with the Ancestral. And yep, Stowaway is good. So I draw my card up to 9. Then Island, Narset, pass. Yep. Yep. Boy, good thing I didn't get my Ancestral Duress. That would have made me feel silly. But just powering up my Murktide Regent. And no land drop from the opponent. So it looks like they were kind of counting on the Suspicious Stowaway to help them with their land drops. I'm going to go Land Sower. The $1 million question is, do I want to activate the Narset? I think the answer is yes. Yeah, I like everything that's going on here. So this is the one shields down moment that I have before I'm going to start passing with the known mana drain. And even though this is shields down on mana drain, I do have Force of Negation. So it's almost like my opponent needs to play a really powerful creature card this turn in order to stay in the game. Thief of Sanity. All right. All right. Well, I'm going to attack with the Stowaway. That's definitely first things first. Discard Island, I guess. And then the Murktide would cost me 4 mana. So there's nothing that I can play while still holding up Mana Drain. I could just pass the turn. And then decide, like, when my opponent attacks with the Thief, am I blocking with Sower? Am I flashing in Subtlety? I think I think just like I'll trade off the sower against the thief and then factor fiction. And there, you know, if I can cast the Inferno Titan, that's going to kill off the suspicious stowaway. So while there is a little bit of finesse in terms of how I'm actually choosing to use my cards, I think there's no bad path for me to take here. Block. No green yet, I meant. No. What was that? No green mana yet for the Grist. Magma Opus, probably the single most interesting card for me. But likely to take just quantity here. Yeah, I do think this is the best split. This is the one that makes it most difficult on me. But I'll go ahead and take the Remand and the Opus. So now I could play the Murktide on the cheap, could minus the Narset. There's nothing that I can do against the Werewolf, so they can attack the Narset, or I could minus the Narset and then they get to attack me and draw a card. So it's like, what would I choose between a Narset activation or them getting a card? What I don't have a lot of in this deck is just plain old removal. I could hit the Damnation or the Treachery. I might just sit tight on the Narset, honestly. Just let them attack it. What about playing two spells? Is that an option? Not really. Okay, let's see what the Narset delivers. I changed my mind. Damnation. Sure, so just Damnation and then play the pure control game where I never have to tap out. My opponent knows about actually everything in my hand except maybe they don't know about the subtlety. I'm not sure if they know about the Inferno Titan. Jace Vryn's Prodigy. It's a juicy target for the Inferno Titan. How about I remand that? Animate dead. Can get back a sower. If it flips, I can hex mage it. All right, my opponent's seen enough. I think it was just definitely over there and only a matter of making sure I execute carefully. For a control mirror, look, I don't have a very deep sideboard. Could see Wheel of Fortune being okay against a slower deck. Could see Sundering Titan being okay, but that is just usually getting up to 8 mana and casting it. Porcelain Legionnaire. Weakest cards, again, Vampire Hexmage and Inferno Titan, but those actually seem fine. I'll just stick with it. Interesting. So I have Chrome Mox, imprint a blue card, hold up Remand. Very far from casting the Grist. I think I can do better than this. It's almost like a mulligan to six anyway, because I'm going to be down a card from the Chrome Mox. This hand is still pretty bad. I still have colored problems. Yeah, I'm going to go to five. There we go. Back to seven. No duress, no duress, no duress. No duress. All right, back to seven. Sure. Took my demonic tutor. That makes perfect sense. Right. So the advantage of playing Chrome Mox now would be having a force of negation like hard cast. That might be fine if I just think there's no way I'm using Anime Dead anytime soon. Yep. Bit of a problem. Okay. Oh, wow. So I can, you know, mastery on the Magma Opus next turn. I could mastery on the Ancestral now, but I think just setting up for Mystics' mastery is really appealing. Also, it gives me a treasure, which could represent a fifth mana for treachery. So yeah, my turn, next turn, could be fully like treachery and Mizzix's Mastery Magma Opus. But I'm going to have to take a hit. And then if my opponent has like, you know, enough disruption or counter spells, I can be in trouble here. Thundermaw Hellkite. Yeah, as long as they don't have a free counter, this is going to work out just fine for me. Treachery the Thundermaw and then resolve the Opus. Oh, but I do have actually two non-land sources of mana, so I might not be able to filter through the treachery in that way. Yeah, so if I was to treachery, I would then only have three mana. So I have to just go for the Mizzix's Mastery on the Opus, and then that's going to be kill your werewolf, draw two cards, make a token, and then hope to answer the Hellkite the following turn. So 2-1, right? 2-1. How do I feel about losing 2 life? 2 life or a treasure? 2 life or a treasure? That 2 life, you know, when you're at 12 against a 5/5 flying, that 2 life can matter. But I do want to fire the duress right now. Scarab God, Seed Shark. Game could get scary. So let's say they cast the Scarab God. Yep. Steam Vents was the draw for the turn. Now I go to 7. There's one creature in the graveyard right now. It's Suspicious Stowaway. So I think I still, well, let's see. If I treachery the Scarab God, untap my lands, play Grave Titan, they attack me to 2. I can die to a burn spell. I attack them to 9. If they play the Seed Shark, they have a blocker, but they're still dead. So they would have to pretty much draw a burn spell to kill me. Remember, Shields will be down on Force of Negation. If I take the Hellkite, I don't get to attack this turn. I do play the Grave Titan. Then they get the Stowaway. They play the Siege Shark because they're going to make an untapped land drop. And then I can't attack for lethal, but I do have a pretty good position at that point, assuming they don't find a removal. So it's kind of like, what's more likely, that they're going to draw a burn spell to kill me with the Hellkite, or that they're going to draw a removal spell, then they like kill my, you know, my Grave Titan or my Hellkite and then reanimate it, and that's really scary. I do think it's better to treachery the Scarab God and just try to fade one turn. But I hope I don't regret this. I mean, I could also hold the Force of Negation and then end of turn activate the Scarab God. They go to 9, then they go to 8 from the Scarab God trigger. I get to attack for 4, unblockable. I mean, if they don't draw anything relevant, that play wins also. But then I'm going to be end of turn activating, putting Shields down on Force Negation anyway, so they can kill me with an instant speed burn spell. So that's only really better against like sorcery speed burn, which is pretty specific. I think this play is best. Just give them exactly one draw step to kill me, and if they brick, it's over. Here we go. Yes. All right. I'll see you for round two. Hello. Welcome back to match number two. After a bit of a nail biter, I find myself at 1-0. This hand is pretty awkward. I have Remand and Shark Typhoon to cycle into a turn two Narset. It's not the worst. So it would be like Chrome Mox, Imprint Titan, play Misty Rainforest that can get Watery Grave. Assuming my opponent doesn't play anything, I'm cycling. And then I have two shots to find an island, and then I have like a really, really good start. I think it's a keep. It's not the best hand I've ever had, but I think there's enough upside. And then I don't need the red mana, but I am so far away from casting Inferno Titan that I just think that's the correct imprint. Opponent with the good start too. Well, now I can play the Narset, but I'm scared of my opponent just playing like, you know, Questing Beast or some kind of crazy Planeswalker on turn two. I think I should actually go for the Duress. All right. Well, I have, I guess, at least one or two turns before I have to worry about that stuff. Zagoth Triome. This is my one turn where I can sneak in the Narset, assuming my opponent doesn't have like another Mox. Oh, brick. It's too bad too, because the Sower of Temptation is usually amazing in a matchup like this. Right, cashing in the Narset. Oh, I like everything that's going on here. Yep. To hold the confluence or to just draw three. I'm going to go with draw three. Nothing in the graveyard yet, but that will likely change. Wow. I'm loving this. So 1, 2, 3. It's tough from my opponent's perspective because they like they must know that I have a counter, but what can they do besides just play their cards? All right, so there's really no wrong way to do this, but if I mana drain, then I can go Grave Titan plus Animate Dead next turn. So let's do the flashy play for the fans at home. Just gonna use all three black mana. Told you, animate dead on the opponent's creature. That's the play we want. Okay. Well, that from a sketchy start turned into a really nice ending. Sideboard. So Reclamation Sage, I did see Coalition Relic and a Mox. I have access to a little bit of green mana for the Grist. Probably not a great matchup for the Hex Mage, though the Inferno Titan is plenty good here. So just one for one swap Hex Mage for Rex Sage. Could also think about swapping the Urborg for either Swamp, Mountain, or Forest. Damnation is an important one to be able to cast early. All right, I'll swap the Urborg for a Mountain just because Inferno Titan is so good against these decks with mana elves. Loving this hand. That's really good. Oh my god, they hit my Narset. If they have a blue source, that's pretty insane. Okay, they don't have a blue source, so dodge that bullet. Just an island that time. They're not playing into my mana drain. All right, well, I've no play I can make besides just continuing to pass, hoping my opponent casts something. Hit my Reclamation Sage this time. Pretty sick. I remand that. It goes back to my own hand. Not that the Rex Sage is like some amazing card. I can't even cast it right now, but just the little victories. All right, I think Sower is correct. Can protect it with Force of Negation. Maybe I was supposed to Damnation there, and then, you know, you expect them to play a big creature, and then I Sower the big creature post-Damnation. Maybe that's a better line. All right, it's going to be kind of similar outcome anyways, in that they kill my Sower, and then I Damnation. Funny, my opponent's deck looks way different in game one. I thought it was going to be like a mono-green deck, but they're actually relatively heavy on red. Couple more creatures. Sylvan Library. Oh. Well, I could Force of Negation that, but I do have to give up a really strong card to do so. I have the Rex Sage. All right, you have a Sylvan Library. I think this has to be right. Tempting to wait a turn, but I just don't think that's realistic. So Murktide can come down as a 5/5 and counting. I'm short on blue mana, so I can't do the Murktide plus protect it with counterspell thing. Top. No play? Is that possible? Wow. So now I could just jam a creature, or I could pass with counterspell mana. I think I'm just jamming Inferno Titan. That thing kills pretty quickly. Top. Seven, eight, nine, 10 mana for the opponent. Show me what you've got. A Boseiju, don't think that matters here. So I imagine it's just attack for 11, counter whatever my opponent plays, win the game. That wouldn't even do it, because I could just attack with the Tar Pit and the 3 damage from the Inferno Titan. All right, dodge some bullets there, but I am on to the finals. All right, see you there. Hello and welcome back to the finals of this Grixis Control Cube Draft. I'm 2-0, playing for a league trophy, and I've got Ancestral Recall in my opening hand. Let's do it. I am on the draw, though, so this one can get a little scary if my opponent has something explosive. So remember, I do not have any red dual lands, but I can grab the Zagoth Triome, which puts me in a position to drop the Grist. If for some reason I need to, I can also fetch an untapped land and Ancestral myself. Yep. No problem there. All right, so my options are I can Hexmage the Prism. I can play the Grist off the Chrome Mox. I can Ancestral myself. I think I'm going to go for the quick Grist. Hopefully save the Hexmage and get some value out of that at a later time. Definitely scary to let my opponent have 5 mana on turn 3. But it is what it is. I can pretty easily pitch the Inferno Titan because I have no shortage of black or blue mana, and I'm also quite far from casting the Inferno Titan. This is quite the configuration of cards I've put together. Chromox imprinting a double red card, Urborg, cast Grist. Mostly blue spells in my hand. All right, Force of Will pitching Snapcaster Mage. I am A-okay with that exchange. My opponent plays a creature. I have Treachery. If they play a Planeswalker, I have Hexmage. All right, but you're going to steal my Chrome Mox. I don't like that very much. All right, so I think I'm going to just play the Hexmage and not kill the deck. I'm going to allow my opponent then to filter their hand and get some card selection with the deck, but the Hexmage threatens to just attack and kill it at no loss of value, or even out of profit, I should say. And then if they play a blocker, I can remove the blocker with the Sower. If they play a removal spell on the Hexmage, I kill the deck in response. So I think it's okay to let them get the card filtering just this one time. Discarded Swamp Bauble, so they probably have a relatively strong hand if, all their cards are better than Mistress Bauble. Whenever you cast a non-creature spell, create a 1/1 colorless Servo artifact creature token. Target artifact control becomes a copy of another target artifact or creature. All right, you got it. Attack the deck. Kill the Saheeli. All right, we've done it. And I guess I just pass with Fact or Fiction available for the end step. Yes. See, the Hexmage is not that bad as just a value card. It's not embarrassing. Oh man, that is a juicy Fact or Fiction. All these cards are amazing. Like the Murktide is amazing, the Demonic Tutor is amazing, the Duress, I have a feeling will hit well. I think I'm just going to take the pile of three. It's a good split. Like the Murktide and the Demonic Tutor, they are the strongest cards, but I think Duress plus two threats, that is really nice. Holy smokes. Mana Leak, Miscalculation, Time Spiral. Opponent does have access to 6 mana. I don't have a counter for that Time Spiral, so I think I have to take it. And then try to leverage the Shark Typhoon to fight through the counter spells. Cycling. Yep. Opponent does get to see three new cards between the Cycling, Draw Step, Fiery Islet if they want it. And then I'm not going to rush on the Shark Typhoon. Let's take our time, make a big shark that can win me the game. At first I thought I was going to get the Watery Grave, but I guess Mountain makes more sense. Maybe I should have just left that uncracked for a while. Not going to play the Grave Titan into the Mana Leak. Just going to take this turn to cycle Shark Typhoon. This is what it's here for. Advantage in these Counterspell Mirrors. Mana Leak and two unknown cards for opponent. So far, my opponent has only played blue and red cards. So far, we don't know what the black is for. Oh boy. Mana Drain matches up pretty nicely against the known Mana Leak because I can just wait and play my most important cards on the Mana Leak turn. On the Mana Drain turn. I think it's better to, you know, I could play the Grave Titan with 9 mana here. I think it's just better to hold up Mana Drain. Interesting. Yeah. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. All right. Shark Typhoon for the win. So sideboarding is going to be interesting here because I have, I think, a lot of weak cards and not a very deep sideboard. Multiple counter spells, right? So I have to worry about just tapping out for expensive stuff. Inferno Titan doesn't seem that great. Chrome Mox is good in my deck, but it's also the one card that's vulnerable to the DAC Faden. So I could see cutting that. Honestly, this Mutavault might not be that bad for pressuring Planeswalkers. What else? My Reclamation Sage is not too bad. Could see the Wheel. Could see the Recurring Nightmare. Hexmage was good. Damnation and Sower are a little weak. I think I'll keep the Treachery just because one of that effect is not bad and Treachery is so good. How about I add Mutavault as an 18th land? Rex Sage. I don't think I like the Wheel on the draw. Sometimes you can deck people with Wheel, and then of course if I do have Narset, but I feel like if I have Narset, I'm ahead anyway. All right, let's try this. Not particularly close to casting any of my spells here. If I had another blue card, maybe I could justify it. I think I need to do better than this. This I'm probably keeping, even though it's pretty scary, and just bottom the Animate Dead. Need to have a land in my top two to be functional. I did board up to 18 lands. Remember, this can search for Zagoth Triome or Watery Grave. So here's basic Swamp. Hey, that 18th land I boarded in. Perfect. Yep. I'm just going to keep Remand available. If I was to Demonic Tutor, I mean, I guess it would be Ancestral, but I kind of just want to land more than anything. Remand is pretty ideal on the Pentad Prism turn. Barl. Well, I remand that. Yep. So Grist, Rex Sage, and Narset are all pretty decent options here. Search for Watery Grave untapped. And I think I should probably play Grist first. Okay, it's a prime target for Reclamation Sage. I think I'm just going to kill the Barl. They can kill the insect. Okay, so I actually should play the Rex Sage first, plays around a burn spell a little bit better. So now I've given them a free loot. Yeah, that was interesting. Like, do I play around a... So what I'm saying is that if you activate the minus two on Grist, you don't sacrifice the creature as part of the cost. You sacrifice it as part of the resolution. So if they kill your only creature in response, they can make your ability not work. So I was kind of choosing there whether to do the Grist thing first, which plays a little bit better against a counterspell, or to do the Reclamation Sage first, which plays a little bit worse against a counter, but a lot better against a removal spell. Given that I had seen counters in the previous game, but no instant speed removal, I think my choice was probably a little bit suboptimal, but as long as I can explain what my thought process was, then hopefully you can understand what's going on there. Okay, I'm going to Force of Negation this, pitching Sower. Okay. Well, Narset is a good solution to the DAC, and eventually the Grist will overpower it. Pentad Prism now depleted. Aha, High Tide. My opponent's got an interesting deck going on over there. Animate Dead can grab the Wreck Sage and destroy the Coalition Relic. I think that's pretty good for me. So remember, they can't use the DAC on themselves right now. That will end very badly with the Narset. Oh no! Poor opponent. All right, activate the Fiery Island, the Narset, concede the game. That is a trophy. That was a 3-0-6-0 from Grixis Control. So not everything was perfect about my draft or my deck, but as I said, if you get to have Ancestral Recall and Mana Drain, that's pretty hard to mess up, and this time it was good enough. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'll hopefully have one more of these Vintage Cube videos coming along, so keep an eye out for that, and I will see you next time here on ChannelFireball.com.